Want to grow a red oak tree from an acorn? Then watch this video. Okay, so if you're curious about starting your own red oak tree from seed, whether you're trying to get some free trees for your yard, plant one of the most important trees for the ecosystem, or just making a fun project with your kids, you've come to the right place, as I've grown dozens and dozens of red oaks over the years. The method I will show you will work for pretty much all members of the red oak family. And red oak family, what do I mean by that? Well, there are over 100 species of oak native to North America. Each of them have their own species name and common name, and all are usually either classified as being in the red oak or white oak group. And what is the difference between red oaks and white oaks, and why does it matter? Well, the common names for red oak and white oak often refer to the color of the wood when cut, in that red oaks have a pinkish hue while white oaks are more of a light brown. But there's other characteristics that are common to each group that dictate how to germinate the acorns as well as identification. So, for the purposes of this video, in almost all cases, acorns that belong to the red oak group need to go through a cold, moist stratification period in order to germinate. This period usually ranges from 60 to 120 days, depending on the species. Contrasting that with acorns from the white oak group, they can sprout roots very quickly after hitting the ground. I show this in my video on growing white oaks from seed, which I'll link to below. So, how to tell which oak you have? Well, nature gave us a pretty quick way to differentiate the two groups. Red oaks usually have lobes that come to a sharp tip, while white oak leaves have rounded lobes. So here is an oak leaf, and these little things here are the lobes where it sticks out. And if it comes to a pointed tip, it's red oak. If it's rounded, it's generally going to be white oak group. So this is usually the biggest clue for differentiating what group your oak belongs to. Of course, you could also use a nice plant identification app like plant.net, iNaturalist, or Picture This, which were about the most reliable ones I found. I did some testing on those. I'll link to it down below. But if you identify the tree that the acorns came from as a red oak, now you can go collect your acorns. Just because you saw some acorns on a tree doesn't mean you should just go pick them, though. The acorns need time to form and ripen, and that's necessary for the acorn to form a viable embryo. If you pick it too early, it's probably not going to germinate. So ultimately, they will be ready when they begin falling off the tree naturally. But once they begin to fall, go collect your acorns. If they're naturally dropping, and you can gather them directly from a tree branch, do so. If you have to collect them from the ground, then go ahead, but make sure for whatever you pick up, twist the caps off and give them a close examination for any holes. Holes indicate insect larvae are burrowing inside and it's eating the embryo. So discard any acorns with a hole. Next, we need to do the float test. Place all your acorns into a container with water and wait 1 to 2 minutes. Any acorn that floats is evidence that the embryo did not fully develop and the shell is holding excess air. Discard those and keep the ones that sank to the bottom. Now, if you're not ready to plant your acorns right away, you can dry them off and store them in a sealed container in the fridge for a couple of months. But don't forget about them, as we need to get these to go through their cold, moist stratification period or be winter sown before the new year. Now let's talk about the cold, moist stratification period that red oaks need to experience. Acorns from the red oak group will not germinate, at least not at a high rate, unless they experience a winter period. This happens in nature by the acorn falling to the ground, then either getting insulated by a thick layer of leaf mulch that falls afterwards, or by being planted via squirrel. So you really need to do this depending on the species, as it can take 2 to 4 months, so plan accordingly. You can achieve this cold moist stratification period by either cold stratifying in a large Ziploc bag filled with moist potting soil and sand for the allotted time, followed by planting, or you can winter sow them. Personally, I find winter sowing is far easier. But for cold stratifying in a baggie, well, you simply take a large Ziploc bag and fill it with moist potting soil that is fully moist. You should be able to squeeze a handful and have a few drops of water fall out. Fill the bag halfway up, place your acorns in the mix, spaced, and then put a few inches on top, seal it, and place it in the fridge for the allotted time. Then plant your acorns after that time. Personally, I don't like cold stratifying in the fridge if I can avoid it, so here is what I typically do. I'll soak the acorns in water for 24 hours, and then I will just plant them in the fall or winter in containers. Oaks will grow a long taproot before you see anything above the soil, and as such, your container should be at least 9 inches deep. But fill it with moist potting soil, leaving a couple inch gap to the top. Place your acorn sideways into the soil, pressing firmly, and then add another 1 inch of moist potting soil above it and place the container somewhere cold. This can be outside in the shade or in an unheated garage or shed. But if you're doing it outside, you will need to protect it from squirrels using either netting, hardware cloth, or some other creative solution. Now, what I'm about to tell you is important. You have acorns planted, and that's great, but you can't let the soil dry out completely. But you also can't let it freeze solid. If it dries out, it will kill the embryo. And also, if it freezes solid, it will do so as well. I've lost entire trays to freezing, so please learn from my mistakes. I like to keep them in my garage and just add a small amount of water once per week. Then I pick up the containers to make sure they have some weight to it. As spring approaches and your garage floor is warming up, the acorns will begin germinating under the soil. In fact, the roots are probably going to start weeks before you see anything on top, but eventually above ground germination will occur. Once this happens, you can let it grow for some time or carefully plant it in its final location. If you happen to put a lot of acorns in a single pot like I did here, you can separate them into individual pots, but be careful doing this. As the taproot gets damaged, you might lose the tree. But use a long screwdriver or a weeding tool to loosen the soil and carefully pull the tree slash root out. While holding it inside another container, fill it with soil as I'm showing you here. Then you need to place the containers in the shade for a few days to avoid transplant shock, after which slowly reintroduce them into sunlight for a couple of hours a day, working them back up to full sun. The best time to transplant seedlings into the ground, though, it's early spring or fall. The cold soil means the sapling won't have much water demands, and the soil generally stays moist during that time. You still need to protect it from squirrels, though, as they will dig up and eat freshly germinated acorns. Ask me how I know this. But cages or 4-foot tree shelters like I'm showing you here work great. I'll leave links to where you can buy them from Amazon if you only need a few, or if you're going full on and want to do a lot, I'll put a link to A.M. Leonard where you can buy them in bulk. But okay, this is about all I've got for you. If you have questions, feel free to ask them in the comments and I will do my best to answer them. If you want to see other tree germination videos, well, I've got them as well, and a lot of articles at my website. I'll put some links below. You all have a good one.